For more than 40 years, the F-16 Fighting Falcon has served as the backbone of the U.S. Air Force's fighter fleet. Today, we will explain how F-16 became one of the biggest success stories in the world of military aviation. Conceived in the early 1970s by a small but vocal group of engineers and defense analysts known as the Lightweight Fighter Mafia, the F-16 was designed as an alternative to fighter aircraft that had grown increasingly heavy and unmaneuverable. A team working out at the Aerospace Division of General Dynamics in Fort Worth, Texas, was designing a new type of fighter to meet the Lightweight Fighter Mafia's ambitious goals. They set out to trade excess weight and heavy payloads for speed and maneuverability to develop a simple, inexpensive fighter that would fly so fast and turn so quickly that adversaries would be unable to strike it with either missiles or machine gun fire. Beginning in 1975, the F-16 design team translated those ideas into the most advanced combat aircraft of its day, leaning on new technologies that had never before been integrated into a single aircraft. Its smooth blended wing body provided extra lift and control. Its critical fly-by-wire system kept the design stable and increased its agility. And its slightly tilted back ejection seat, side-mounted control stick, head-up display, and bubble canopy improved pilot survivability as well as visibility and control. It was sleek and fast, but by the 1980s, the F-16 was tasked to take on more missions, including bombing targets and close air support. So, engineers at Fort Worth added more powerful weapons and targeting systems, without diminishing the F-16's unparalleled agility, transforming the Falcon into a true multi-role aircraft. The F-16's new versatility was put on full display in 1991. During Operation Desert Storm, more missions were flown by the F-16s than any other aircraft. Pilots bombed airfields, military production facilities, and missile sites and then shot down an Iraqi MiG-25 in the tense months that followed the campaign. Since its first production order in 1975, more than 4,500 F-16s have been produced for 26 nations around the globe. As with every fourth-generation U.S. fighter, the F-16 was defined by the Air Force's experience in Vietnam. In the late 1960s, former Air Force fighter pilot Colonel John Boyd and a group of fighter technology analysts known as the Fighter Mafia called for development of a highly maneuverable, lightweight fighter aircraft that would be an alternative to heavy, complex fighters like the F-4 Phantom, F-14 Tomcat, and F-15 Eagle, some of which were still in design stages. This idea gained funding and quickly evolved into the Lightweight Fighter Program. In February 1972, six manufacturers submitted design proposals, all based on two prime considerations: turning radius and acceleration. 2 months later, the General Dynamics Model 401-16B and the Northrop P-600 were chosen for development, and a 300-hour fly-off at Edwards Air Force Base in California, known as YF-16 and YF-17. The prototypes both weighed in at about 20,000 pounds empty, which was relatively light compared with the 28,000-pound F-15 and the 40,000-pound F-14. A team including General Dynamics chief designer Harry Hilliker rolled the YF-16 out in December 1973, just 21 months after the development contract was placed. The diminutive, largely aluminum single-engine design incorporated a cropped delta wing, blended with the fuselage body, forward wing strakes, an underslung intake, and aft underbody ventral fins contributed to a dynamically unstable configuration, controlled by the world's first fly-by-wire production flight control system. Combined with a 23,840-pound thrust, Pratt & Whitney F-100 PW100 afterburning turbofan, the purposely unstable design offered a 1.4-to-1 thrust-to-weight ratio, eyeball-popping 9G maneuver capability, and exceptional pilot visibility under a frameless bubble canopy. But the YF-16 still needed to provide itself against Northrop's competition. After 10 months of testing, it was clear that the YF-16 had significantly better maneuverability, a longer range, and a lower cost than the YF-17. In January 1975, the Air Force pronounced it the winner of the competition, and said Uncle Sam would buy at least 650 of them. But the YF-17 didn't disappear into obscurity. It would go on to form the bones for the US Navy's future FI-18 Hornet. Despite its initial lightweight, day fighter emphasis, the F-16 would immediately develop into a multi-role fighter bomber. As the LWF was underway, NATO allies Belgium, Denmark, the Netherlands, and Norway were on the lookout for a replacement for their Lockheed F-104G Starfighter fighter bombers. The similarly sized, single-engine YF-16 fit perfectly. The US Air Force was also looking to cost-effectively replace the fighter-bomber capabilities of its F-105s and F-4s with an aircraft that could mix with the air superiority-focused F-15. These imperatives drove changes to the first production F-16s, which included a longer fuselage, increased wing area, larger ventral fins, and two more underwing weapons stations. A larger nose radome also accommodated a Westinghouse AN, a PG-66 radar. As a result, weight was increased by 25% over the YF-16. The US Air Force accepted its first production F-16I in January 1979. The 34th Tactical Fighter Squadron became the first unit to fly the F-16, which was officially named Fighting Falcon in July 1980. By that time, two European production lines had been started and the Belgian, Royal Netherlands, and Norwegian Air Forces began receiving F-16Is. So did the Israelis. The Israeli Air Force called the F-16 Nets, or Hawk, and threw it into combat less than a year after taking delivery. In July 1981, the IIF launched Operation Opera, which saw 8 F-16Is, each carrying two unguided 2,000-pound bombs, boldly fly into Iraq escorted by 6 IIF F-15Is, where they struck a nuclear reactor. The Fighting Falcon's first aerial victories came courtesy of the IIF in April 1982, when a net shot down a Syrian Air Force MiG-23. That June, Israeli F-16s took on more Syrian MiGs during the conflict in Lebanon, ultimately being credited with 44 kills. Its early success in combat combined with its relatively low cost and versatility made the F-16 a hot seller. By May 1982, Venezuela was already the 10th Fighting Falcon customer. In April 1983, the US Air Force Thunderbirds demonstration team flew its first public air show with F-16s. From Turkey to Thailand, the F-16 was in high demand. Today this fighter is or has been operated by 26 countries and 4,588 have been built, making the F-16 the second most produced American supersonic jet fighter after the F-4 Phantom. According to Lockheed Martin, there have been 10 production blocks of the F-16, from Block 1 in 1979 to the latest Block 7072, generically known as the F-16V. Between countries, blocks, and models, a total of 139 versions of the jet have been produced over the past four decades. Over the decades, the F-16 has unofficially been referred to as the Viper. The name was given it by early F-16 pilots at Hill Air Force Base in Utah, reportedly referring to its look before takeoff, or to spacecraft in the popular late 70s sci-fi series Battlestar Galactica. Retired US Air Force Lieutenant Colonel Dan Hampton went on to fly 151 sorties in the Viper during both Gulf Wars, becoming one of the most decorated Air Force pilots since the Vietnam War. The F-16, he says, was and is an ideal suppression of enemy air defense's mission platform, owing to its small size, which makes it hard to spot on radar or visually. Its modular design making upgrades easy, and its agility. The great thing about the Viper was that you could do the air-to-air fight on your way into and out of the target area, Hampton says. In the second Gulf War, they sent all the F-15 Sea Eagles home after the first 10 days. They weren't needed because we were there. F-16 production is still going strong at the plant in Greenville, South Carolina, owned by Lockheed Martin, which acquired General Dynamics Aircraft Business in 1993. Right now, there's a 128 jet backlog for the latest Block 7072 version ordered by five nations. Among those nations is Taiwan, which will put F-16Vs to vital use facing China across the Taiwan Strait. Taiwan's new Block 70 Vipers will leverage advanced scanned array radars, more powerful General Electric F-110G 132 engines, and IGM-158C long-range anti-ship missiles to dissuade China. With the U.S. Air Force extending the lives of its older F-16s to 12,000 flight hours, the aircraft could possibly serve into the late 2030s, and the U.S. Air Force's recently muted desire for a non-stealthy, multi-role fighter to replace many of its Vipers could see it revisit the aborted Delta Wing F-16XL, among other designs. For the present, F-16s around the world will add to the more than 19 million flight hours flown by the type to date. But with all its abilities, its best feature is also its most important one, taking care of its pilots. "It's a great airplane," Hampton says. "It always brought me home alive and I'm grateful for that." Many military pilots refer to the F-16 as the Viper because of its similarities to the head of the snake. The F-16 was the first fighter jet to use a side-mounted control stick. The stick lets pilots rest their arm while flying, giving them better control of the jet in high G maneuvers. With its high thrust-to-weight ratio, extreme maneuverability, and pilot ergonomics and visibility, the F-16 has been one of the most respected and feared fighter aircraft of the past 40 years. In 1976, Tech Sergeant Joseph A. Kirtle, photosensor shop supervisor for the 1st Tactical Fighter Wing, MacDill IFB Florida, won the Name the Plane contest with the name Fighting Falcon. He won a free dinner at the MacDill IFB NCO mess. Please subscribe to our channel and turn on your notifications not to miss our future releases. Thank you for watching Nick's Defense.